Zendis, I don't believe you missed the Skella battle. I think that's still coming up. We've never played this game before, and whoa.
That was weird.
This is a big town. Oh, and, Derby wants to know, how natural are seedless fruit?
Seedless fruit?
Yeah. Although, maybe that wasn't aimed at you. What lady? The lady with the bunny? Or the orange lady? The artificial orange lady? And yeah, Blaze, artificial orange.
Is that Flapjack?
Wait, maybe female Flapjack? Is that a bow?
It might be.
Huh. Striped shirts are kid fashion, apparently.
That's politics. Okay.
Is that guy's head made of fire?
Yes. It's Hades. He said he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch the stuff.
I don't know. Oh, also, BadgerBat suggests looking at the lesser dog and then looking at the greater dog.
Okay.
I'm sorry, what was that about butts?
He said he wanted to see someone slip. He said he wanted to see some of the hicks slip and land on their butts.
I see.
Okay.
I can't disagree with that statement.
Wow.
Well, at least he's honest. Okay then. Also, BadgerBat makes a good observation. That comment about the collar could be taken as literal because he's a dog, or as a fetishistic leaning. That is pretty amazing. Well, Zenda says that some people, some NPCs in this game have two lines of dialogue and reset to the first line when you leave the room. Just so you know.
Uh-huh.
That's adorable. Apparently, some of the people outside, just wandering around the town, have a couple different dialogues, a couple different lines of dialogue. Not all of them, but some.
Yeah. Oh, so it's like a little reptile kid.
Oh. Also, Derpy Science is going sleepy sleep now. Okay. And so is Gas Mask. Oh, thanks for watching.
I wonder if the weird skeleton is an adult or a kid. That's a good question.
Is the game poking fun of itself now?
Maybe.
So Badger Bat's gonna hang around until the next boss fight, which I'm assuming isn't too far away, but, you know.
I might have to end at the next boss fight, too.
Oh, well.
Whoa, what the fuck is that thing?
Well, one could be an anteater, but the blonde thing, I don't know. And the thing next to it, I don't know. Oh, the next boss fight is outside the town to the right. Blaze, I'm assuming, is talking to you. Wants to know if you have any original characters.
Lots of original characters.
He has a buttload of original characters.
Yep.
And they're all pretty damn cool, if I might say so.
Let's see. Jazzy's definitely the best.
Yeah, Jazzy is Jazzy Drive is probably his most popular character. I mean, oh. She even has a fan club on DeviantArt, so...
It hasn't been touched in ages.
It hasn't been touched in ages. he can't draw, so he can't show off his.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Huh.
Aww.
Excuse me.
History Part 4. Fearing the humans no longer, we moved out of our old city home. We braved harsh cold, damp swampland, and searing heat until we reached what we now call our capital. New home. Again, our king is really bad with names. I totally gotta get Patook this game. He'd freaking love it.
He would! I mean, you guys have been playing Earthbound 3 off and on, so this would be right up his alley.
monsters are mostly made of magic. Human beings are mostly made of water. Humans with their physical forms are far stronger than us. But they will never know the joys of expressing themselves through magic. They'll never get a bullet pattern birthday card. Okay.
What?
It's a school report about monster funerals. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. When monsters get old and kick the bucket, they turn into dust. At funerals, we take the dust and spread it. Spread it on that person's favorite thing. Then their essence will live on in that thing. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kind of sick of writing this. Nice.
Also, Badger Bat explains that what you just read, that's part of the reason why Toriel would die in like one hit if you hit her. But I still like to think that you just shattered her. You just broke her heart, you know?
Yeah.
Apparently the library sign is misspelled.
That's what it says.
The sign actually said it?
Yep. It says library.
I gotta wonder if there's any explanation in-game for that. Because given how much detail is in this game, it wouldn't surprise me if like one of the NPCs just randomly says, yeah, the library's got a misspelled sign. What is going on?
That's what I was wondering.
Oh, don't forget to go to the north part of town. Well, too late now.
Hi, Papyrus.
My head is itchy.
Admiration for another problem-solving skills, a desire to have cool, smart persons think you're cool. These feelings, they must be what you are feeling right now. I can hardly imagine what it must be like to feel that way. After all, I am very great. Yeah.
So before we get into combat, I have to ask, Badger Bat, does anything bad happen if you actually use the stick on Papyrus? Or is it just like some awesome goofy Easter egg? Okay. Nothing bad happens if you use the stick on Papyrus. Just remember to use it as an item.
That is pose.
A great sprite and pose.
That is so flamboyant. Butts pie.
Where did you get butts pie?
Oh, I accidentally put the stick into the inventory box. Darn it.
Ooh, well.
It's the butterscotch pie, cinnamon butterscotch pie.
Oh, I get it.
He likes to say, nyeh.
Flirt with him, see what happens.
Yeah, was flirt an option?
Oh, yes.
I guess so. We're going to spell to very high standards.
I have zero! zero redeeming qualities.
So I can make spaghetti and says, oh no, you're reaching all my standards.
Oh, flirting with him, I guess, was the correct? No, never mind.
Oh my god.
Flirt more. Oh, I guess that's it. sorry.
Alright, looks like I have no choice but to insult him.
Keep flirting with him, apparently. That's what Jack says. And Blaze, his name is Ass Cat, because why not?
Pretty much.
Oh, hey, I just remembered something. Remember what that frog told you a while back? Yeah, you got it.
Yeah.
I'm 5 seconds behind, but you got it. Wow. Imagine what a nightmare that would be if you, you know, actually moved.
Oh.
Wait a minute, you're blue now. What does that mean? Oh, it kind of turns into a platformer when you're blue.
MTT brand anime powder behind his ears.
Anime powder? That's a neat gameplay mechanic. Well, he must not want to capture you very, you know, very much if he's giving you all these hints. Attraction slime, huh? So apparently if you'd said you had no redeeming qualities, he would have said that your humility reminds him of himself.
Oh.
So I think it would, ultimately, it would have been the same difference, but that's, you know, good to know.
After all the stuff he's put behind his ears, Papyrus realizes he doesn't have any ears.
Well. Also, I forget who said it. I saw this earlier, but, oh, here it is, Xenthus said that if you happen to lose this boss fight, you actually don't die, basically. Oh. But I'd say, you know, win it anyway, because why not? Spaghettiatore?
I got a real spaghetti obsession.
Well, you might actually end up dying after all. That seriously is a cool sprite, though.
It is. I'm just wondering how long I have to do this.
Well, you do still have... Wait, didn't you buy some items? Oh, you probably shouldn't have eaten that. course, I'm the kind of I'm the kind of person in an RPG that, you know, tries to keep all the unique items. I don't know if you'll ever run across butterscotch pie again, but eh. Yeah, Zenta says the pie is actually
full heal.
Full heal, yeah. And it does have one Easter egg at the very end of the game. I knew it! But it's just for a particular boss, so it's, you know. Oh, Zenta's also adds, not that it matters, because in pacifist runs, pretty much everything is a full heal anyway. You don't gain experience, you don't gain levels, therefore you don't gain any HP. So the better the items, it's going to be a full heal.
Oh, well.
And that's why the bicycle is
so useful.
Because it's like 11 times 2, so that's a full heal right there.
I'm starting to wonder if I'm doing the right thing.
I wish he would just use his damn special attack. Ow, that explains that. Jackmar says if you sleep at the end, it'll overclock your health. But, no but, that would explain why you had 30 health earlier.
Yep.
Apparently Zenthus has played through this game 6 times or so now. Which tells me this is a friggin' good game with a lot of replay value. I hope he's serious about that. I mean, this is a fun boss battle and all, but damn it. That was totally worth it.
That's hilarious.
That was. That regular attack is a doozy. Holy crap.
What? Wow. Huh?
Okay. Okay. Please don't tell me there's like a fast moving bone that zips through behind that slow one. Well then. That was fun. Such a cool dude. Alright, take care, Badger Bat. Thanks for stopping by.
See ya.
What a loser. I love it when games give you that option.
I've already managed to hit the friend zone.
Wow. Just wow. Also, Badger Bat grabbed the hula hoop, got into a bone costume, and hopped off on a skateboard. What do you think of that?
Alrighty. That's a cool dude.
Huh? Oh wait, before you go that,
go north.
Yeah. Okay, why is it getting? Oh, okay. I was gonna say, why is it getting like impossible to see again? Oh yeah, Jakmar suggests saving again, real quick. Oh, well, that's his home then.
Well, yeah, it said that it was his mailbox at one point.
Ah, I missed that part.
I like that you're given an option to where you don't have to fight. I think that's really neat.
80 gold is really expensive, but kind of worth it, too. Because it gives you 10 extra health.
Yep. And she gives me my money back anyways, because I didn't stay overnight.
Wow, what a nice innkeeper.
Because she said I was only in there for 2 minutes.
Yeah, I didn't catch that the first time around either. She never charges you. I wonder what would happen if you tried that in real life, like just go into a random hotel and like pay for a room, and then come down like 2 minutes later and go, I'll be leaving now.
Wow.
So, apparently, somebody was throwing those into the river. But,
this game is
according to Jakmar, you notice the kids are gone now.
Hmm. I wonder what happened.